My name is Adam Yamaguchi, and I am both a correspondent and the executive producer of Current TV's Vanguard documentary series. We are airing a three-part special entitled War on the Border.
Policia! Policia!
This entire project took about 6 or 7 months, and we had determined that reporting on the border between the U.S. and Mexico, was an issue that we wanted to tackle from multiple perspectives. And, you know, the first part of the project really sought to give the audience a sense of the desperation that people must feel to be willing to risk life and limb to make this crossing into the U.S.
All right, right now we're going into talk to the coyote.
One of our correspondents, Christoph Putzel, actually does an illegal border crossing.
Finding a coyote who was okay with our camera equipment was one hurdle. Finding one that we and the padre trusted was another.
This is the coyote who may be able to take us on Tuesday.
Puro arroyo, donde camina
agua. The route that he would take is nothing but canyons.
Does anyone else take that route?
Muchos usan y muchos no.
There's a lot of barbed wire you have to cross
through.
Es peligroso? It's dangerous?
Todo es peligroso.
He and his team had spent some time down in Altar, Mexico, which is just south of the border on the other side of Tucson. And this is a small town that really exists for the express purpose of smuggling would-be border crossers illegally across the border through the harsh desert of Arizona. And what we were attempting to do was to get a better understanding of the migrants' experience in getting from just south of the border and into cities such as Tucson, such as Los Angeles. And we were a little nervous about the idea of making that illegal border crossing because it's inherently risky. It's incredibly dangerous, but as we began reporting the story, we realized that there was no way around it. We had no other choice but to go and show, document for our audience what that crossing looks like. The second portion of our special explores how the Mexican drug trafficking organizations have really been able to gain quite a bit of a foothold here in the U.S. They now control up to 70% of the U.S. drug market. And most surprising to us, and really at the initial stages of this story, we were all sort of stunned by the fact that, according to many reports, marijuana is now the most important, the most lucrative and profitable drug for the drug trafficking organizations and the cartels, more so than cocaine, heroin, meth combined. That's a serious, serious business. And we don't often look at marijuana in much the same capacity as we do some of the harder drugs. It seems to, you know, be considered a softer drug, one without any real consequence, when in fact it is incredibly important. In fact, some will say that marijuana sales here in the U.S. Is essentially what funds the cartel's ability to traffic in meth, cocaine, and heroin. So it's a critical part of their infrastructure.
Two guys that were here tending this grow said that there are upwards of 4,000 of these plants throughout this grow site here. They look pretty benign, but on the California market, this could fetch $8 million. On the East Coast, they could go upwards of $12 million. It's insane.
What I think is most striking is, in some ways, our connection to this. This is a country that is right next door. It's a huge trading partner of ours. Its economy is very closely tied to ours, and Mexico has spiraled into becoming one of the most dangerous places really in the world. And if you dive a little bit deeper and you look at the violence that's taking place down there, you know, this is drug violence. And the drug violence, you know, these cartels are largely fighting over trafficking routes to get their drugs into the U.S. What I think this series will open people's minds to is just how closely linked we are.